Hello! Like many of you, I use Visual Studio Code every single day. That's why from time to time, I like to contribute to the open source project on GitHub. If you want to see your name in the next release notes, let me show you how it works. In my case, I already got 8 pull requests accepted and 5 more are pending review. Before jumping to the Issues tab, make sure to read the documentation and understand the rules. readme.md already tells you some interesting information and has the links to the relevant pages based on what you need. For example, how to submit a pull request, how to contribute to translations, or how to request a new feature. You might also want to read contributing.md that tells you, for example, that questions do not go on issues on GitHub, but rather on Stack Overflow, as the community can better assist you. Did you know that? Well, read the docs. Moving on, Visual Studio Code has a huge documentation that you can find in the Wiki tab up here. On the right side of the screen, you can find a table of contents showing all the useful information. You can also contribute with pull requests to this wiki as it's hosted on the repository vscode-wiki. For now, let's get back to the main repo and open how to contribute. Like many other repos, if you're new to the project, the Microsoft team suggests you to look for labels help wanted and good first issue. However, we'll get into that later, as the goal right now is to set up the project on your local machine and make sure that everything works smoothly. The requirement list looks quite big, but most of them you probably already have installed, like Git, Node or Yarn. In my experience, I had some troubles with the C++ compiler for Windows because I had to install a thing from Visual Studio, but on my MacBook everything was just there. When you're ready, you can fork the project and clone it locally. Open it with your favorite IDE, might be VS Code, and run Yarn to install all the dependencies. It might take a few minutes for the first time, but that's okay. When it's complete, the quicker way to build and run is with the shortcut Ctrl-Shift-B or Command-Shift-B if you're on a Mac. This will automatically open two terminals and the build will start in watch mode, so that every time you change something in the code, it gets automatically recompiled. But how does that work? Well, you can find on the .vscode folder a tasks.json file and there it is. You can also set this up for your personal projects, by the way. Now, as soon as you see the tick icon on both builds, core and extensions, you can finally run the application. To do so, as written in the docs, just open a terminal and run scripts/code.sh or code.bat if you're on Windows, and there it is! You successfully launched VS Code from the source code. Cool, isn't it? Now, in order to see if it's working, just grab a file as it could be getting started and change something like the title. Then go back on the OSS compiled version and nothing happened. Even if the build is already in watch mode, every time you change something, you should also reload the app with Ctrl-R for Windows or Command-R for Mac. And then you can see the result. If you're a web developer, I've got great news for you. You can open the Quick Pick menu with F1 and run the command Toggle Developer Tools to have the Chrome tools running in your VS Code instance. For example, I easily found the Get It Started file because I inspected the code and found the CSS classes of this title. Then, with a global search on the code, I found the right file. You can read from here console logs, but you can also use the debugger to inspect step by step your code. Let me show you. A slightly different way to use the debugger is by launching the OSS instance directly from VS Code. To do so, head over the Run and Debug tab and click the Play button. You can also use the shortcut F5 to achieve the same result, a VS Code instance with a VS Code debugger attached to it. If you like automated testing, VS Code has smoke, unit and integration tests. All you need to know is inside this readme.md file inside the test folder. Smoke tests are inside the test/smoke folder, while unit and integration tests are inside the test folders spread across the code. Unit are named with .test.ts and integration, as you might guess, are .integrationtest.ts. As written in the docs, and similarly to running the application from command line, in the script folder you can find the scripts that will execute the tests. Unit tests are written using Mocha, and unsurprisingly, since VS Code is a Microsoft product, Playwright is the suite that runs integration and smoke tests. When you run unit tests, you can also check the coverage, and as you can see, it's not really high. So if you want to contribute, you might consider adding more tests. Great! At this point, we have a better understanding of the project, we know how to set up locally, run the tests, and debug. So, what's next? We can finally go back to the Issues tab and find one to work on. Like I said in the beginning, you should search for labels Help Wanted or Good First Issue. Help Wanted issues are the ones the team will prioritize when it comes to reviewing and accepting your pull requests. This label highly increases the chances of getting your PR merged. Issues with the good first issue labels have a fast lane on reviews like Help Wanted, but are usually smaller and perfect to the confident with the code base. You might also want to filter for the bug label, but this can be quite tricky. In any case, if you find a good issue but you have some problems and no idea where to start, feel free to ask in the comments for a code pointer. Someone from the team will be happy to let you know which file or even line to look at to get started. If you watch the video up to this point, you really have everything you need to start contributing to Visual Studio Code. While writing the script for this video, I was thinking it could be interesting if I record another video where I pick up an issue myself and I show you all the process from writing the code on the project up to creating the pull request and waiting for the review. Let me know in the comments if you think this could be an interesting content for you. When the video will be out, I will probably add something over here that you can click to directly get to that video. To wrap up, today we saw how you can contribute to the Visual Studio Code repository by submitted code. But as I say many times in this channel, writing code is not really the only way to contribute to open source, and this also applies to the Visual Studio Code repository. You can also see in this other video here many other relevant actions that keep open source projects growing. Click the like button on this video if you want to support the channel, and go watch the other video if you want to learn something more. See you soon!